We wanted to see if people that suffered a sports concussion recovered differently if they immediately stopped playing and came out and were evaluated, or if they continued to play and then later were found to have a concussion. We found that in college sports, athletes that sustained a concussion and stopped immediately returned nearly 3 days sooner than athletes who continued playing, maybe just for a couple plays on to even a full practice or several days even.
One of the main reasons we wanted to look at this was we know that not every athlete is immediately coming out of a game or practice as soon as they have a concussion. And the message has always been, if you think you have a concussion, tell someone right away and you can get evaluated. But there's not really ever been a lot of incentive or reason for the athletes to do this. With these findings where we showed that those that did immediately remove themselves, I think we're giving a reason to follow up on what's been the message all along, which is if you suspect you have a concussion, tell someone so you can get evaluated. Some people might be surprised how frequently people aren't immediately removed. Pressures of athletes are a real thing. There are certainly circumstances where they feel like it's more beneficial to keep playing and they might not recognize that staying in is a problem. Athletes might not know that the symptoms they're having are because of a concussion. Concussion symptoms sometimes present later on. So there's a lot of reasons this might be happening.
Our sample mixed contact with non-contact sports. We have football to golf in there, and we found that it seemed to hold in all sports, so it didn't necessarily involve taking another hit. Even just continued exertion seemed to be a factor. If you stop, let us evaluate you, and even if you are ultimately diagnosed with concussion, you're gonna get back faster, so you miss less time overall.